Welcome to the Daily Mass from St. Anne's Basilica in Scranton, Pennsylvania. The Passionist community of St. Anne's Monastery is happy to bring you this celebration of the Mass to enhance your daily devotions. May God hear your prayers today and grant you His abiding peace.
Behold before our wandering eyes, beyond the gates of paradise, shines out the tree of life adored, the cross of Jesus Christ our Lord. Behold before the glorious wood upon which hung our only good. It bore Him up in offering, the Lamb whose praise the angels sing.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of the Lord Jesus, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And let's pause and remember our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to live among us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you died and rose that we might live. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you send us forth to proclaim your good news. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May our loving God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, direct our actions according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son we may abound in good works. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The children of Israel set out from Ramesses for Succoth, about 6,000 men on foot, not counting the little ones. A crowd of mixed ancestry also went up with them, besides their livestock, very numerous flocks and herds went with them. Since the dough they had brought out of Egypt was not leavened, they baked it into unleavened loaves. They had rushed out of Egypt and had no opportunity even to prepare food for the journey. The time the children of Israel had stayed in Egypt was 430 years. At the end of 430 years, all the hosts of the Lord left the land of Egypt on this very date. This was a night of vigil for the Lord, as he led them out of the land of Egypt, so that on this same night, all the children of Israel must keep a vigil for the Lord through all generations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. From out of the depths I cry unto you, Lord, hear my voice, come hear my prayer. Oh, let your ear be open to my pleading. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. If you, O Lord, should mark our guilt, then who could stand within your sight? But in you is found forgiveness for our failings. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Just as those who wait for the morning light, even more I long for the Lord my God, whose word to me shall ever be my comfort. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went out and took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. When Jesus realized this, he withdrew from that place. Many people followed him, and he cured them all. But he warned them not to make him known. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through Isaiah the prophet. Behold, my servant whom I have chosen, my beloved in whom I delight. I shall place my spirit upon him, and he will proclaim justice to the Gentiles. He will not contend or cry out, nor will anyone hear his voice in the streets. A bruised reed he will not break, a smoldering wick he will not quench, until he brings justice to victory. And in his name, the Gentiles will hope. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
When I first read this gospel in preparation for today's Mass, I was struck by the beginning part where Jesus realizes the difficulty that he's in, and he tells the people that he's reaching out to, that he's curing and preaching to and so on, he tells them, don't tell anybody about me. He's doing that for a very specific reason. He knows they're out to get him. He knows that some of the leaders of the people want to put him to death. Well, that got me thinking, and it's dawned on me over decades now, that there's an awful lot of Christians, there's an awful lot of Catholics who seemed hesitant to tell people about their awareness of Jesus in their lives. They seem to feel like, I'm not supposed to talk about that publicly. That's kind of a me and Jesus thing. Well, that's not what he was intending in this gospel. He's intending there to let things play out in their proper time, and eventually he will publicly make his place, and they will get him. And we all know the story, and that's why we're here. But for us, we are the servants that he's chosen, the ones that he's going to put his spirit on, that we don't need to go out and cry out and preach at people in the streets or things like that. But we need to be people who are able to express our faith among our friends, among our neighbors, among other people that we find ourselves associating with in little ways, especially this time of the pandemic, when so many people are depressed and upset and just their whole lives are kind of misconfigured, and where can we get any help? We need to share our faith in Jesus. We need to share that he is still with us, that he died and he rose, and that he's now relying on us to share the good news of who he is and what it is that he has done for us. Think about it. Think how you could share your faith more effectively. Amen. Let's place our needs before our God. For your own needs, those of your family, and those that you associate with, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the people most affected by the pandemic, that they are provided the resources they need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering under prejudice or other misfortunes of the attitudes of others, we pray for their freedom and their fullness of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have no one else to pray for them, we ask you, Lord, to send others to be with them and support them and sustain them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And loving Lord, thank you for your gift of yourself. Help us to share ourselves to assist others. We make this prayer as always in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Only this I want, but to know the Lord and to bear his cross, so to wear the crown he all but this is loss, worthless refuse to me. For to gain the Lord is to gain all I need. Only this I want, but to know the and to bear his cross, so to wear the crown he wore. I will run the race, I will fight the good fight, so to win the prize of the kingdom of the Lord. Only this I want, but to know the Lord and to bear his cross, so to wear the crown he wore. Let your heart be glad, always glad in the Lord. So to shine like stars in the darkness of the night. Only this I want, but to know the Lord and to bear his cross, so to wear the crown.
My brothers, my sisters, let's pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his God's name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, with Joseph our Bishop, with all the clergy, the religious, and all your holy people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Anne and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And now, with the Savior's command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let's offer peace to each other, including those at home.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Shall we gather at the river, where bright angel feet have trod, with it crystal tide forever flowing by the throne of God? Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river, that flows by the throne of God. On the margin of the river, washing up its silver spray, we will walk and worship ever all the happy golden day. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Ere we reach the shining river, lay we every burden down. Grace our spirits and deliver, and provide our robe and crown. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God. Soon we'll reach the shining river, soon our pilgrimage will cease, soon our happy hearts will quiver with the melody of peace. Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God.
And let's pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that receiving the grace by which you bring us to new life, we may always glory in your gift. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May our loving God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let's go in the peace and the joy of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim, till all the world adore his sacred name. Led on their way by this triumphant sign, the combine. Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim, till all the world adore his sacred name. So shall our song of triumph end. the crucified for victory. Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim, till all the from the whole race of men. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. Sweet child of election, deemed worthy to bear the Virgin of virgins, Christ's mother most fair. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. Look down on our sorrow, give ear to our plaint. Behold our afflictions, O powerful saint. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, pray for us.
Good day to all of you, and welcome to St. Anne's Basilica, where we begin our solemn novena in honor of St. Anne today. As we do so, we welcome our first preacher for our solemn novena, reflecting on the mystery of the cross and its presence and power in our lives. His name is Father Robert Jerger. Father Bob is how he goes. Father Bob is originally from a small town called Brooklyn, New York. Grew up in Bay Ridge and the Brooklyn, which is not the Heights, but it's next door to the Heights in Washington Heights. But he grew up there and after high school began to think about maybe God was calling him to Passionist priesthood. And he went and joined in our college residence program in Assumption College in Worcester, Massachusetts, where he earned his bachelor's degree, went on to novitiate and became a professed member of the Passionist community, and followed that by 4 years of theology studies at St. John's University in New York City. After ordination, Father Bob worked in the television radio ministry for a bit. He followed that with a good number of years as the coordinator and superior and retreat director for St. Gabriel's Retreat House for Youth, serving mostly high school teenagers from New York City and Long Island at the time. After that, Father Bob was elected to our provincial council, the advisory council to our provincial superior. He followed that by himself becoming our provincial superior for 8 years. After that, he was chosen and elected as a member of the advisory council to our general superior in Rome, where he traveled the world visiting various Passionist sites and communities, giving the encouragement and support they needed to continue their work. Following that, he came home again from Rome and was elected our provincial superior for a second 8 years. Took a little bit of a breather after that and is now pastor of St. Teresa of Lisieux Parish, a very nice parish at the end of Long Island on the eastern shore of Montauk, New York. So we're very pleased that he's taking his time out to be with us and to share his reflections on the cross with us. And we want to welcome Father Bob as we begin our novena.
Thank you, Father Richard. And so let's begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Incline unto my aid, O God.
O Lord, make haste to help me.
And let us pray. O Almighty God, Father of mercies and giver of all good gifts, we kneel before you to honor you and your saints, and to seek their intercession in our many needs. We are truly sorry for all our sins, and humbly ask your pardon. Please grant our petitions and a full measure of the indulgences granted by your vicar, the Pope, and draw us ever nearer your divine heart.
Amen.
In our prayer to St. Anne, with a heart full of sincere and filial veneration, I prostrate myself before you, O blessed St. Anne. You are that beloved and privileged creature who, because of your extraordinary virtue and sanctity, did deserve of God that chief of graces of giving life to the treasury of grace, the blessed among women, the mother of the incarnate Lord, the Blessed Virgin Mary. I, in consideration of such exalted favors, please, O most tender saint, receive me among the number of your truly devoted servants, for such I profess to be, and wish to remain for the rest of my life. Surround me with your efficacious patronage, and obtain for me from God the imitation of those virtues with which you were so profusely adorned. Obtain for me a knowledge of my sins and sorrow for them, an ardent love of Jesus and Mary, and a faithful and constant observance of the duties of my state in life. Save me from all the dangers in life, and assist me at the hour of my death, that I may safely reach paradise, there to praise with you, most happy Mother, the Word of God, made man in the womb of your most pure daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Mother of Christ, Mother of Christ, what shall I ask of thee? I do not sigh for wealth of earth, for joys that fade and flee, but Mother of Christ, Mother of Christ, this do I long to see, the bliss untold which thine arms enfold, the treasure upon thy knee.
And so I'll now bless any rosaries and religious articles you may have with you, that they may be a means of deepening your personal prayer with the Lord Jesus. May these rosaries and religious articles and all who use them be blessed in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our first reading is taken from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones, and a time to gather them together. A time to embrace, and a time to be far from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rent and a time to sow. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts, without men's ever discovering from the beginning to the end the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to be glad and to do well during life. For every man, moreover, to eat and drink and enjoy the fruit of all his labor is a gift from God. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus came to Jericho and intended to pass through the town. Now a man there named Zacchaeus, who was chief tax collector and also a wealthy man, was seeking to see who Jesus was. But he could not see him because of the crowd, for he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree in order to see Jesus, who was about to pass by. When he reached the place, Jesus looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, come down quickly, for today I must stay at your house." And he came down quickly and received him with joy. When they all saw this, they began to grumble, saying, "Has gone to the house of a sinner." But Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Behold, half of my possessions, Lord, I shall give to the poor. And if I have extorted anything from anyone, I shall repay it four times over." And Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because this man too is a descendant of Abraham. For the Son of Man has come to seek and to save those who have lost their way." My brothers, my sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I want to thank Father Richard very much for inviting me here. He's a good friend and a brother, and we've lived and worked together for many years. And when we were studying theology in preparation for the priesthood, we had a wonderful professor, a passionist himself. I'm sure he was the best teacher I have ever had. His name was Father Aelred Lacamara, and this is some advice he gave us before we were ordained. He said, "Brothers, a teacher gives people content, but a preacher helps them to fall in love." Maybe during this novena, we'll fall in love again. You know, we all have a life story, every single one of us. And maybe at the beginning of this novena, you might want to ask yourself, what's your story? And where has love led you in life? And where might love be inviting you to go, even right now? You know, when you read the Gospels, the wonderful thing is that Jesus always meets people where they are and not where anyone else thinks they should be. And so today we meet a man named Zacchaeus who was really kind of hated by his neighbors. He was a tax collector. He would extort money from them. He would put money in his pocket and then take what he needed. And there was really nothing that they could ever do about it. And yet, Zacchaeus is so hungry, so suffering. You know what's interesting? Almost nowhere in the Gospels is anyone described physically. I mean, we have no idea what Jesus looked like. We have no idea what Mary looked like. We may know that one or another person is blind or deaf or has leprosy, but we don't really know what they look like. So why do we know that Zacchaeus is short? Maybe because he can't see above the crowd. I mean, have you ever in your life felt crowded in or in a rut or desperately wanting to break free? Or have you ever felt diminished or invisible or looked down upon? The gospel tells us that Zacchaeus pushed love away big time. Was he a bad guy? I don't know. Reminds me a little bit of the Danny DeVito character in Taxi. But he was a guy who did some very bad things. No matter how much he owned, it was never enough. Gotta have more, gotta have more. He's stuck, he's alone. And here's a secret. Whenever in the gospel you read that Jesus passes by, like he did with Zacchaeus, it means there's gonna be a Passover. Something is gonna die so that something may live. And he comes down from this sycamore tree, a very rough tree with some rough patches, and Jesus calls his name. And you know, when somebody calls your name and looks at you with love, it changes everything. And he asks him, "What are you really looking for?" And for Zacchaeus, and maybe for us in life right now, maybe that's the same question. What are you really looking for? What are you willing to let go of in order that you may grow? Because no matter how flawed we are, no matter how much we come up short, no matter the compromises we've made or the secrets or the skeletons we might have, no matter where we might be broken, like Zacchaeus, every one of us is given a moment of grace through the power of the cross to come to new life. You know, to end, my dad, as you know, some of you, was brought up in Honesdale, and you know, he had terminal cancer, and I remember going in and the hospice nurse saying to me, "You got to give your father permission to die." And And I went in there and I asked him if he was afraid. And he said to me, afraid of what, Bob? He said, afraid of dying? He said, no, I'll be with your mom again. He said, there's only one thing I'm afraid of. He said, that's leaving you by yourself. I said, I'll be okay, Dad. I got the community, got the parish. He said, yeah, but they all have some place to go for Christmas, you know? And he said, I got some money. And he said, he gave me that money. And he said, you've been a good son and a good priest, and I want you to do what you want to do with your life. You know, it's funny. Sometimes I wish I could be half the man my father was. You know, I never had to work three jobs. I never had to pay the rent. I never had to put food on the table. I never had to change the diapers of my wife, who had Alzheimer's for 5 years every single day. I wish I could be half the man that he was. But you know, I went in to give him permission to die, and he turned it right around, and he gave me permission to live. I think that's what this gospel is all about. I think what the cross is all about, maybe what this novena is all about. Permission. Permission to seek that which gives us life. And the road to love, we can be down a lot of different paths and journeys. Sometimes it's straight, we know exactly where we're going. Other times there's turns and dead ends and we wind up in the ditch or we get lost and we don't want to ask for directions, whatever it is. But maybe during these days, whatever your story is, you can give God permission and let the cross raise you up. Amen. Amen. So let us continue our novena prayer, and we join with our Passionist family on this 300th anniversary in our prayer to Jesus crucified. Lord Jesus, for how many ages have you remained imprisoned upon your cross? You constantly stretch forth your hands to recreate us and to embrace us with your love and to heal us through your wounds. Our names are written in your heart forever. You have loved us with an everlasting love. Your cross shows us the power of your love, a love that is stronger than our fears and sins of the past. Lord, let the love that flows from your cross embrace us, break down the walls of our fear and sins, and fill our hearts with hope for your healing grace. Lord Jesus crucified, teach us how to love and care for one another as you love us, even to the cross. For by your cross and resurrection you have set us free, and by your wounds we are healed. We pray now to Saint Anne to obtain a special favor. O glorious Saint Anne, filled with compassion for those who invoke you, and with love for those who suffer, heavily laden with the weight of my troubles, I cast myself at your feet, and humbly beg you to take the present affair, which I recommend to you under your special protection. Please recommend it to your daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and lay it before the throne of Jesus, so he may bring it to a happy issue. Please continue to intercede for me until my request is granted. Above all, obtain for me the grace of one day beholding my God face to face, and with you and Mary and all the saints, praising and blessing him for all eternity. Amen. Good Saint Anne, mother of her who is our life and our sweetness and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Good Saint Anne, mother of her who is our life, our sweetness and our hope, Pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Good Saint Anne, mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us poor sinners, now at the hour of our death, amen. And good Saint Anne, pray for us. Through the intercession of Saint Anne, may God grant you health in mind, body, and spirit, and may God grant you every blessing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Hail Mother of Mary, O gracious Saint Anne, God's marvelous choice from the whole race of men. O good Saint Anne, Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, Saint Anne, pray for us. Sweet child of election, deemed worthy to bear the Virgin of Virgins, Christ's Mother most fair. O good Saint Anne, Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, Saint Anne, pray for us. Look down on our sorrows, give ear to our plaint. Behold our afflictions, O powerful Saint. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. O good Saint Anne, pray for us. Proclaim.